One of the most obvious things that happens is that young teenagers start to grow amazingly fast. Faster than any other time in your life apart from when you were a newborn baby. The growth spurt usually takes off for girls at 10 or 11 and for boys a few years later. Boys will keep on growing for longer and usually, on average, end up taller than girls. But there is a time, usually around 12 years of age, when boys feel like we are being left behind.
Now, most adults have forgotten that growing can actually hurt at times. Growing pains in your arms and legs, your knees, your joints, they're really common, and it can occasionally make it hard to sleep. Unfortunately, there isn't heaps you can do about growing pains, but if you're in a lot of pain and it doesn't go away, you might want to talk to a doctor.
You know, a lot of people check their height on a growth chart on the wall. That way you can track how much you are growing each month or year. Now, some of you will grow 8 to 10 centimetres in a year and put on 5 or 6 kilos of weight. If you keep growing at that rate, then by the time you're 30 years old, you could be clotheslined by power lines or honking a giraffe or get a job rescuing cats from really high trees without climbing a ladder. Weird, I know. But of course, the rate slows down again, so that by the time you're 18, you're about as tall as you ever gonna be.
And the thing that makes teenagers feel, I guess, most uncomfortable or embarrassed through this time is that they're nearly always growing at different rates from their friends. So the growth spurt can vary a huge amount. It can vary because of health or how well you were fed during your childhood. But most of all, it just seems to depend on the way your body is programmed to grow by the genes you've inherited from your parents. If your parents and older brothers and sisters were early starters and grew, you know, quite young, chances are you will be as well.
Some of you will be taller than some of the teachers before you even leave primary school. Well, that'd be cool. And others might only grow slowly all the way through high school. And so especially at intermediate school age, you might find yourself a lot taller or shorter than your same age friends. And either way, you might feel embarrassed.
No one likes to stand out really and be, you know, really different from their friends. And I guess most teens want to appear normal, especially as other kids can be cruel. They can joke and tease if you're different or stand out. So it might seem funny to them, but like it might not be funny to you. I reckon everyone wants to be normal, but this is the trick. No one seems to realise that at this stage and this age, it's actually normal to be different.
Hang on. It's actually normal to be different?
Yeah.
Are we different?
We're quite different, so we're both very normal.
How do you handle the likely event of being or feeling different? You might be the shortest person in your class. Maybe it's a temporary thing and you'll eventually catch up, or perhaps you're going to be a shorter person all your life. For perfectly normal reasons, reasons like your legs aren't as long as other people, or other people's legs are longer than yours. How are you going to handle it though?
You may stand out because of your height. And again, it might just be a temporary thing, or you might always be a taller person. Being shorter or being taller can affect how you feel about yourself. There isn't a magic wand, but there are a couple of things to think about.
Other people probably don't think about it as much as you do. Even if they call you a nickname like Shorty or Tallie, it probably doesn't mean that they are rejecting you as a person. Name calling is a sign of immaturity. It's usually done because they want to feel better rather than make you feel bad. They want people to laugh, not at you, but at what they think is the funny thing that they have just said. They probably don't know how it makes you feel, and they'd probably be horrified if they found out it made you feel bad. They are just being immature. What they say about you is probably more about their own insecurities.
We're not going to pretend these aren't real worries for you. They can be real worries. Your bodies might be fit and healthy and attractive, and yet because our society does seem to have ideas about how tall or how short we should be, we can end up feeling insecure at times. And this is what I'd love you to know. If you're tall, that's awesome. You can reach stuff off the top shelf. You can slam dunk. You can see if people have nits.
And if you're short, that's awesome. You find more money off the ground than tall people. You always win limbo competitions. And you don't know if your friends have got nits, so that's got to be a good thing. There are good things and bad things about being short, and there are good things and bad things about being tall. Choose to focus on the good things more than the bad things.
What about dealing with teasing when people call your names? You could listen to them. You could believe that what they're saying is true. But have you ever used a nonstick frying pan before? The one your mum gets really angry about if you don't use the plastic spatula. Don't use the tongs. It won't be non-stick anymore. It'll just be a sticky pan. Okay, well, I think one of the best skills to learn is how to make your ego a non-stick ego. If people mock you because of your height, you tell them something like, well, I may not have chosen to be this tall or this short, but there's nothing much I can do about. It's a fine height. My legs are just the right length to reach the ground. And what I am as a person and the value I have as a human being doesn't depend one bit on how many centimetres I measure up.
But generally, if you can hold your head high, smile and appear to ignore it, then your confidence will take the fun out of the name calling.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it doesn't work.
Don't bite.
You're non-stick, man. Continue to act in a friendly way, deflecting their insults with humour. And I'm sure that if you want them to be your friends, they will be your friends. I doubt if it will ever stop hurting a little bit, but you can make their words hurt a lot more by taking their cruel words, agreeing with them, and beating yourself up with them. Remember to be a non-stick frying pan, no matter what size you are. Hey, how about a couple of questions?
Okay. For the adult, when did you have your growth spurt? What age were you?
For the kid, have you ever felt way taller or shorter than your friends?